Hello, boys and girls. Today is Good Friday, and as believers in Jesus, we celebrate Good Friday. What is Good Friday, you might ask? Good Friday is the day that Jesus went to the cross and died for our sins. Before he went to the cross, he had a special supper that he ate with his disciples, and it was called the Passover. And when he was done eating, he took bread like this. Back then they had wine, but it was red like this. Today I got a coolness. And he said, the bread represents my body, and the wine would represent his blood. He wanted us to share with him in this time of him offering his body, which would be broken for us, and the blood that would be shed for us. And he said that we should do that as believers. So on Good Friday, we take time out to remember what Jesus has done for us. And we may even do communion. Well, I've got a video for you that I'd like you to watch to help understand better what Good Friday is all about.
Hi, I'm Michelle.
And I'm Lisa, and we're really glad you've joined us for Good Friday.
Yeah, today is such an important day to remember what Jesus did for us, but I feel like sometimes we overlook how important today really is.
Yeah, it's true. Jesus knows everything we do and everything we think, and to be honest, we don't always live perfect lives, but still, Jesus chose to die for us.
Yeah, it just reminds you that no matter what, Jesus will always be here for us. Let's check out today's God story with Carmen to find out more about our big idea. We may fail, but Jesus will never fail us.
Hey everyone, I'm Carmen. Today is an incredibly important day in the memory of the church. It's a tough day, but perhaps just the most important day. It is the day that Jesus shows us just how much God loves us. It's the day when Jesus showed us that he will never fail us. And that brings me to today's big idea. We may fail, but Jesus will never fail us. Last time, we heard about the disciples eating with Jesus in the upper room to celebrate Passover. And then they walked together to the Mount of Olives and sang a song. And when they were walking, Jesus told them that they would all desert him, based on a prophecy that was made hundreds of years earlier in the Old Testament book, Zechariah. And then Jesus told them that after he rose from the dead, he would go ahead and meet them in Galilee and see them again. Do you remember our very excited disciple friend Peter? He turned to Jesus and he said, "Others may turn away from you, but I will not." Peter was promising Jesus that he would not fail him. Let's read in Mark 14 what Jesus had to say. "What I'm about to tell you is true," Jesus answered. "It will happen today, in fact, tonight. Before the rooster crows twice, you yourself will say three times that you don't know me." Three times? Peter could not believe that he would ever say he doesn't know Jesus. He said to Jesus, "I may have to die with you, but I will never say I don't know you." And all the others said the same thing. Next, Jesus took his disciples and they went to pray. He told most of them to sit in one spot, and then he took Peter, James, and John with him, and they went a little further. He told them that he was very sad and that he was close to death. And then he asked them to stay awake and keep watch, and he went a little further and he prayed. He fell to the ground and he prayed and he cried, and then he prayed more. He knew that what he was about to do was incredibly tough, but that it was something he had to do. Then Jesus went back to see Peter, James, and John, and when he found them, they were sleeping. Jesus said to Peter, "Are you asleep? Couldn't you stay awake and keep watch for 1 hour? The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." Jesus told them he would go again to pray, and again they fell asleep. This happened one more time. Can you imagine how Jesus must have felt? His disciples couldn't even do the one thing he asked them to do on this, the night of all nights. Just as Jesus was speaking this time, Judas, the disciple who betrayed Jesus, showed up, and with him there was a crowd of people carrying swords and clubs, which were the weapons back in those days. And they arrested Jesus, and they took him to the high priest. Peter followed because he was trying to see what was going to happen to Jesus. The priests and the others told different stories about Jesus because they wanted to put him to death. but none of their stories agreed with one another. They had no proof. So the high priest said to Jesus, "Aren't you going to say something?" But Jesus stayed silent. So then the high priest said, "Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?" And Jesus said, "I am." And in him saying that, he broke their religious laws. And so that's how they could find him guilty. And they said he had to die. And so they took him and they beat him and they treated Jesus terribly. Now remember, Peter was watching all of this from a distance. And it was at this time that a woman approached Peter and said, "You're with Jesus." Peter denied it and said, "No, he wasn't." And he tried to walk away, but the woman said again, "This man is with Jesus." Peter again said, "No, he was not." A little while later, a man came up to him and said, "You must be with Jesus because you're from Galilee." Peter once again denied it, although angrily this time. And it was exactly at that moment that the rooster crowed a second time, just like Jesus said it would. Peter broke down and cried. He must have been feeling so terribly. He must have felt like he had failed Jesus. They decided to crucify Jesus. Crucify means to kill. And so they took him out to a place called Golgotha. Golgotha means the place of the skull, and they nailed him to a cross. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him, and above his head they placed a sign that said, "King of the Jews." At noon, darkness covered everything, and this lasted for 3 hours. It was at this point that Jesus took his last breath, and he died. Now in the temple, there was this curtain that separated the Holy of Holies from the rest of the temple. And the Holy of Holies was the space where God's presence lived. At the moment when Jesus died, that curtain was ripped from top to bottom, from heaven to earth. Nothing would separate us from God anymore. A Roman commander who was standing in front of Jesus said, "Surely this man must have been the Son of God." Good Friday is a tough day because Jesus died, but it's an amazing thing too. Jesus showed us just how much God loves us by dying for us. Jesus also shows us that he will never fail us, and it isn't the end of the story. Spoiler, he doesn't stay dead. And that's why today's big idea is, we may fail, but Jesus will never fail us. As we remember Jesus' death on the cross for us, aren't you so glad that is true? I know I sure am. As we go today, remember just how much Jesus loves you. Well, that's all for today. See you next time.
We just heard that the temple curtain was ripped from top to bottom the moment Jesus died, and that's a powerful physical reminder that Jesus removed any barrier between us and God, and that God wants a personal relationship with each one of us.
Yeah, and sometimes we feel closer to God than not, but because of what Jesus did for us, nothing can separate us from God's love.
Yeah, and we're gonna hear a story now from our friend Mateo. He was hurt really bad at one point in his life. He even felt like God wasn't there for him. Let's see what happened next.
My name is Mateo, and I'm a hip-hop dancer. As a guy, for me, it was very hard at first to take dance class and to tell others that I do dance, because I get a lot of criticism every day. Even today, I get criticism from everybody, but they don't understand that this is my passion, this is what I love to do. And if you're one of those people, then you should just go for it, because it might open a lot of doors in the future for you. My relationship with my sister, it's kind of like back and forth. Like, we have a weird way of communicating. Sometimes we just don't want to see each other, and other times we just want to spend time together and do things. And especially like dancing, that's something that brings us together. Things took a turn for the worst when my parents got divorced. And that was a really hard part in my life for me, because it really broke me to see that my parents weren't together anymore. But I knew it was the best for my mom, because it was just really hard to see what she was going through. After that, the church seemed to be on my dad's side and to be kind of biased. Instead of helping us, they were tormenting us and manipulating my mom to try to get her to go back.
They told me that I just had to stay in the marriage, that I wasn't following God. I never felt that they supported me. I didn't get a phone call. I was lost. Me and my kids were left alone.
After that, we decided not to go to the church anymore. My relationship with God just kind of fell apart. and I didn't really feel connected to him as much because the people at the church were making me view God as a God of anger and unjust. And they made me really hate the idea of the community and a church. Through my friends, I ended up coming to a different church. And at first, I wasn't really excited for it because I didn't believe in a church community. But when I sat down in the church and I listened to the pastor preach, I heard the word of God coming through his mouth. And it showed me that God never left me and that he always still loves me.
Here I experienced Jesus. I experienced his love and his kindness through people that didn't even know me. They were willing to help me. They were calling me all the time, anything you need.
Random strangers from this church would donate furniture to furnish our home. And I couldn't believe it at first that random people could love and show the love of Jesus and give it to us. God never really left me, and I realized that even though I didn't like him, he really loved me. Looking back at my old church, I realized that they didn't really experience the fullness of God and the love that he has for us. Now coming to this new church, I realized that Jesus loves me no matter what. And it's just very impactful for me. If people hurt you from what they say, you should walk away from the people and you shouldn't walk away from God.
It is amazing to hear the way Mateo and his family experienced the love of Jesus through their new church family, even though they'd experienced so much rejection in the past. His story shows us that Jesus never fails us.
Yeah, and what Mateo said was extremely important. When people turn against us, don't turn away from God. No matter if it's school, family, friends, God will always be here for us, no matter what.
Yeah, absolutely.
Wasn't that a good video? I thought it helped me understand better why we celebrate Good Friday. Will you pray with me right now? And let's talk to Jesus for what he has done for you and for me. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for giving your life on that cross. Thank you for dying for my sins. Thank you for surrendering your life so that I could live. Thank you for being the sacrifice that was needed. And today on Good Friday, God, we just take time out to remember how good you are and how you've given yourself up so that we could have eternal life. And we simply say, thank you, Jesus. We love you. We give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a good, good, good Friday, boys and girls. And I'll see you on Resurrection Day.